All right, welcome back to SoFlow TV again, everybody. It's your host with the most, taken right from The Observer. This one says, "Unacceptable" by Kimone Francis, okay? The article says that several Jamaicans aboard the Morella Discovery 2, which has now docked in Southampton, England, have retained services of attorney-at-law Jennifer Howson as they fight for justice. So shout out to all the people who agreed with me that it was freaking wrong to send these Jamaicans sailing to Portugal and sailing on the high seas when they were close by enough to just grab our citizens, quarantine them at home, and let them go home to their families. You're talking about people who work on ships for a living out at sea, right? And here they are now. Finally, they have docked in, they have allowed to dock in the UK, and they have reached out to an attorney because I'm sure they feel their rights were violated and they're planning on suing. So in an interview with the Jamaica Observer yesterday, Howson, which is the attorney, a former People's National Party caretaker, disclosed that the family of the crew members who did not make it into the country despite being in Jamaican waters on April 2nd, reached out to her for assistance. Howson said that she has since written to the Minister of Foreign Affairs and Foreign Trade, Senator Kamina Johnson-Smith, requesting that the Jamaican government communicates with its United Kingdom counterpart to accommodate the Jamaicans who have not been allowed to disembark the vessel. So although they have docked in Southampton, they are still on that ship. So for the people who want to know, SoFlow, tell us more. We want to know what's going on with these few Jamaicans. Because deportee, plane load of deportees just came to Jamaica and they were accepted because they had no choice but to accept them. Right? Donald Trump said, I'm sending your doggone deportees back to you and you better take them or else sanctions up your wazoo. And he sent them. Matter of fact, they were scheduled to arrive on Wednesday and they arrived on Tuesday instead, one day earlier. And they surely made room for them. So they damn well could have made room for these Jamaicans, right? There are a lot of people that are saying, I hope these Jamaicans bond together and put up a class action lawsuit against the government of Jamaica because their civil rights were violated. Their constitutional rights were violated. And it was. So according to Howson, on March 17th, the Jamaican government accommodated the 1,622 passengers from the Morella Discovery 2 who were predominantly British and Canadians, allowing them to disembark in Jamaica for flights to their home countries, citing humanitarian grounds. At that time, Jamaica had already confirmed its first COVID-19 case. She said that unfortunately, the same was not done for more than 40 Jamaicans who were denied a request to disembark from the cruise ship weeks later when the vessel re-entered Jamaica waters. And of course, you know, there was excuses put out there as to why they couldn't. And then the Prime Minister with his own excuse of, oh, me never find out until after them leave bossy. And these kind of things, right? The Observer earlier this month reported that the ship arrived in Jamaica waters for refueling on April 2nd. Of course, they counteracted that by saying it wasn't in Jamaican waters. It was in something called the California Bluff, which was 12 miles off of Jamaican waters. Listen, 12 miles out to go get your own people, two Coast Guard vessels and grab them and bring them back to shore would certainly not have taken that much out of them, right? But anyhow, so the ship arrived for fueling April 2nd, at which time the captain made a request to the government for the Jamaicans to disembark amid travel restrictions related to this whole the C word thing. But with no response forthcoming, the Jamaicans were told that the vessel had no option but to move on. I've seen a lot of ignorant Jamaicans blaming the captain of the vessel. And I'm telling my audience this, that captain has a schedule to keep. Okay, and he did wait for 24 hours. The question is, why did it take the Jamaican authorities 24 hours to decide that they wanted their own people or they did not want them? Why did it take them 24 hours? And not only did it take them 24 hours, I will publish the video that I already recorded of exactly what they said. Makes no damn sense. Anyhow, Prime Minister Andrew Holness on March 20th announced that effectively March 21st, the country's air and sea ports would be closed to incoming traffic for 14 days. That has since been extended some more. The decision was revisited and an extension was granted until March 24th. On April 4th, the Prime Minister announced an extension of said travel restrictions for a further 14 days. The restrictions are now scheduled to end in a week, but I think I heard today that it will go on for some more time. They are currently in the UK. For those of you who want to know where these Jamaicans are, they are currently in the UK. They are still on the vessel though. Although they have been allowed to drop anchor or stay right there, stop, they have not been allowed to disembark the vessel. Since they got to the UK, various nationalities have been allowed to disembark and have been repatriated to their home countries. So persons from Indonesia that were on that same ship, persons from Mexico that were on that same ship, persons from Chile that were on that same ship have all been allowed to disembark, and they have since gone to their home countries. Y'all listen to this, right? Y'all listening to this, right? The Jamaicans, they have heard nothing still. Nothing. So we have seen the Prime Minister saying that they're doing controlled entry and planning, but nothing has been communicated to the Jamaicans on the ship or to the captain of the ship, the attorney Housen has stated. Now let's get this clear. We keep speaking of the 43, but we need to realize that these are Jamaicans like you and I. They are not just some numerical figure sitting out there like the 43. These are people, okay? Jamaican people with families, hardworking, law-abiding, tax-paying citizens, people. They are representing Jamaica on these cruise ships. And the fact of the matter is that they ought to be treated as such. You understand? The attorney told the Observer that while her clients, who wish not to be named, have a legal case against the government, their primary concern at the moment is just to get home. She added also that as their representative, she is now advocating for exactly that, to get them home. So it is not a question of, we're going to sue the government. Whether or not that occurs is neither here nor there. Do they have a cause of action? If you're to ask me as a lawyer, absolutely. But is that their primary concern right now? No, it is not. Their primary concern right now is their own safety. Their safety of passage back to their home of their citizenship, which is Jamaica. Their families are worried. They're concerned. They're distressed. And they need to get back home to their families. It is literally sitting in a sea of uncertainty. Literally just sitting there. Everybody else has disembarked and gone home to their country. And the Jamaicans are sitting there. Yesterday, the Observer spoke to Marie Campbell, the mother of one of the Jamaican crew members, who claimed that her daughter and her colleagues aboard the ship are just mentally drained, man. Campbell said that while there have been no reports of any cases of this COVID-19 thing aboard the ship, her daughter and others have been restricted to their rooms. They're on the ship locked in their rooms. They have been restricted to their rooms. She said, too, that communication between her and her daughter has been very limited. She's very frightened right now, she said. This is her mom. For all you wicked-ass Jamaican people who like to praise and worship your doggone politician more than holding them accountable. Oh, look for me, good up president. Man, then I saw him look without suit. Hey, sir, you need to wear t-shirts more often. Him sexy. Him look like him body firm and him can't go the distance. This is the kind of comments that are being made. And then when asked about these people out in the waters, make them turn out there. Android do the right thing. Here's a mother that's very worried. And this is one of our biggest problems. I've spoken about it before. It is our inability to put ourselves in the position that our brothers and sisters are in. Empathy, it's called. Empathy, the ability to put yourself in a position where someone else is, to see yourself in that position and to be able to say, wow, I would not like this for me. I would want some kind of justice. Nope. What we practice doing is looking the other way until it is us that is in that position. Then we want to cry, oh, the world, please help me and cry for me and cry with me. The mother is explaining that her daughter on the ship, that they are locked in their rooms. They have been quarantined to their rooms on the ship. You ever been in these ships and seen a room? She's saying that her daughter is frightened right now. She said them isolate her, so she in her room by herself. This is like being in isolation in prison. She's isolated in a room by herself, and I'm sure food is not in there at her leisure. So it's not like you're home and you can go to the fridge and take something out to eat. You know what I'm saying? And drink when you're thirsty. I'm sure they will be feeding them on a schedule. This is prison. More time when she called me. She said she really feel lonely and she just want to come home. She just there not knowing what is happening around her. Imagine that. Put your mind in that. You're locked in a room on a ship. Everybody else has disembarked except for you and your crew, right? From your country. You're in a foreign country where you are allowed to stop there, but not allowed to get off this vessel. Worse now, you cannot roam the ship anymore. You can't go out on the deck or get some fresh air. You are locked in your room. She just there not knowing what is happening around her. And she's feeling very lonely. She's locked in that room by herself. And it's the same thing with her co-workers. She said, them lock them up too. She explained. She said with one daughter stuck aboard the vessel and another one unable to return home from the United States, the family is uncertain of how to proceed with the money it now has drying up. Campbell, who has been diagnosed with cardiomegaly and is also battling kidney disease, is currently caring for 4 grandchildren and her 78-year-old mother. Her daughter often sends money to help with all these expenses. As she take care of me, she said, I have her daughter here with me, so she helped me pay the bills. Pay my mortgage and every little thing. It hurt me a lot that she cannot come home, but I cannot do anything. I just have to wait and see what the government doing. She paid the mortgage for last month, but this month, I don't know what's going to happen because she have fear own now to pay too. It just really, really hurt me. Our 6-year-old daughter talk about her a lot. More time she's saying she don't want anything to happen to our mother, so she would like for her mother to just come home. She out here lonely, locked up in our room. More time she a wander on a fret. She worry about me because I have to go out with my condition to get food. And so for everybody else, I don't have anybody else to do it for me. She a hear the news of what's happening out here, so she's scared. Said Campbell, who lives in Trenchtown, St. Andrew. And of course, y'all see what's been happening in St. Andrew, right? So there is her vulnerable mother, who she is a big part of taking care of, that is now thrusted into the position of taking care of her 6-year-old, plus her ailing self and her mother and 3 more grandchildren. Housen, in the meantime, is urging the government to move swiftly to get these Jamaicans home. She said with the UK requiring transit visas, the Jamaican government will need to lobby the British government to waive any requirements in order to get its citizens home. Wow. So you trying to tell me that the British government can't just step in and say, listen, they can't just sit there forever. They have to go. Let them through. We keep referring to the US and the UK and Canada as our partners. And at some point, the part in partners needs to engage. And at this juncture, what I'm saying and asking the government or the minister to do is to use whatever leverage we can as partners with these countries to get them to waive any kind of visa requirements or restrictions in order to get them from the port to a plane to their home. That simple. According to Housen, which is the attorney, it is not unreasonable to ask the UK government to extend similar courtesies to the Jamaicans as was extended by the Jamaican government to their citizens on March 17th. Wanna hear that? As their attorney, I am advocating on their behalf. I'm not coming in heavy-handed here. I'm simply saying that this is a constitutional right. And this is not displaced by any other means of displacement that may be set out elsewhere within the Constitution. I'm not drawing for that. I'm simply saying, let us work together in a way that will allow these persons who have these rights, who are Jamaicans and have the right to enter their country, to be allowed to do so, she added. Asked about the implications for admitting the crewmen aboard the Morella Discovery 2 into the country while other Jamaicans are unable to return home, Housen said that the situation is unique. It is very unique indeed. We didn't have those persons sitting within a mile of home and then denied by their own government. So, whilst I understand that there are persons who may want to come home, it is in my view that the Jamaican government at this juncture has a legal duty to those persons who were sitting offshore their own country to have let them in, to have let them depart and be where they are now. It is on them. They need to fix that. And that is exactly what I have said all along. Lindell McCormack says, I am not a lawyer, but I am not sure if this is really a legal issue. Perhaps those who are versed in constitutional law might see it differently. However, the lawyer retained is a criminal lawyer. Perhaps the families have money to waste, or is politics involved? I'm not even going to read any more of these stupid, ignorant comments. All I'm going to say is, this was a big blunder on the part of the administration, and they need to fix this as soon as possible. No more long talking. End of story. Leave your comments in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about this one. And don't forget, the one bag of deportees them that just came into the country today, and they accepted them. I'm out. Peace.